Alright, now we're going to make a North Pole speaker box. It's a little bit more involved. It's more involved for me than it will be for you. You're going to laugh the way I do this. And, so laugh it up! Alright, so, remember I was telling you that some of these come with, little problems? See how this, like, looks like carbon is kind of in the plastic? That's a second. So this will be the bottom. So I sandwich them together like so. They kind of go together when I make a North Pole speaker box, so I have to sandwich them together. So my second will be the underneath, and then what the customer sees will be what's on top, a nice one. This one's nice.
So nice.
So I gotta remove the Rubbermaid sticker off of these guys. Now the first step is that the one that goes underneath needs to have it cut away. It needs to be cut away. And you can see, let's see. See these little bumps? See these bumps? I cut above these bumps. You actually, just to really show you what I'm gonna do here. Let's see what I got. I'm basically going to cut that line right there. So it goes from this bump to this bump. I'm going to take it right off. So if I was using my jigsaw, I would just blast that right off. And I'm going to use an X-Acto knife because I don't feel like making a bunch of noise and sawdust. When I use my jigsaw, it makes such a mess that I spend up all day cleaning my room. So I'm going to use an X-Acto knife. And then break it. So I'm gonna set up for that. Alrighty, I've scored three of these sides. I've got one left to do. So the way I've been doing this is I take the clampets here. This is Jed. This is Granny. These are handy to have for everything. Get these photo supply. Probably have some if you don't. You should get some. They're great. And I just score it with my X-Acto, so then later I can break it with a pair of pliers. It just pops. It's actually good enough. Take off Jed. Take off Granny. Love the clampets. Good people. Just don't mess with Granny. She's snappy. Here's another great tool. Alright, use the blunt side. And I just kind of rock and roll these apart. And it works for me. So I sit and do all of these. I could do a whole box of the anything that's like got any kind of mess to it. So when I first get these plastic boxes, I go through and I establish which ones have, like, carbon in the plastic. Carbon in the plastic. And I realize that those are going to be my bottoms, and I just kind of cut all my messy ones that I wouldn't want a customer to see the low quality of the Rubbermaid product. And that way, my tops are all pristine. This comes off really easy this way. In fact, you know, I've got no complaints at all with doing it this way. It all comes off real good. My pliers are ideal for this sort of thing. I just kind of toss this in my recycle bin. There we go. Now, one thing, because I'm just picky and nuts, I have one of these. This is an art supply tool. It's sharp on three sides. It's called a scraper. So just kind of clean it up. Get rid of anything that would hurt someone's fingers. So this is a North Pole speaker. I know it's a North Pole speaker because I hold a compass to its face and the N is attracted to the face. Whenever I go, the N. There you go. The red has plus for positive. Blue is the ground. We're gonna get rid of those. I'm not gonna use them now. So this is my North Pole speaker. I put the North Pole speaker as centered as possible. I flip it over and hold it up to the light. When I hold it up to the light, I can see the speaker. Now the box already has a circle embedded in the plastic. It's kind of from the manufacturing of it. Must be like the mold. So I line up the shadow around the circle that's actually in the plastic. And when it looks lined up, see this? There's the plastic line. There's the shadow. Plastic. Shadow. So I just line those up. And once I have them lined up, so I just take my pencil. Make a circle. So there you have it. Now you know where this is going to go. When you just run a ring of hot glue and that into place. Real easy. So now you've got that ready to roll. Once again, this box has a ridge. The ridge, I consider the back. So the front is smooth. On the left, I need to drill a 1/8 inch hole at the top. Because if I don't put it at the top, the bottom will interfere with the wire. So I'm going to drill 1/8 inch hole at the top center of this side, just like this. There you have it. I did it. It's done. Now, these banana to alligator leads, they come, they're either batched together, a black and a red, or they come as a single red. The single reds are made for these North Pole speaker boxes. And other things. We use the singles for a synchrometer and a bunch of stuff, so I use them for various projects. But for this one, we don't need the alligator clip. That's what happens when you don't need an alligator clip. So now we just have a banana plug. Pretty cool. Very simple. I wheedle this right in through there. I bring it to about center point. I'm going to tie a knot here. The knot makes it so when people pull and tug and drop it and do things, it doesn't mess up the solder point. So now I have plenty of extra wire in here, and then this will solder to the plus positive only. So when you're making a North Pole speaker box, you don't use the ground at all. It's Remember when we were testing the zappers that when the red was plugged in, the positive, it still read the frequency? Well, RF frequency runs through the positive all by itself without the ground, and North Pole speaker box works only when it's not grounded. So I'm going to clear some wire off here. Give it a little bit of a twist. That's going to solder right here to the plus. So that's my ultimate plan. So let's solder that baby. So I got a few suggestions about soldering this. I say make sure you got ventilation. Big loud ass fan will be good. And I've made this fan all by myself. It's just a computer 12 volt fan, something like that. Yeah, 12 volt. I got a 12 volt adapter and just made it, and that way it sucks the fumes away, so I'm not sucking fumes. In other words, I'm sucking fumes. So I extend this wire all the way out of here. And I set this speaker down. And I'm going to solder this just to the plus. That's all I'm doing here. Now I've got a piece of, we got some Radio Shack. rosin core solder. Good stuff. So we're gonna solder it. I got this other tool that I got at Radio Shack. It's just a thing. God knows what this is. So we're gonna do it. I'm warning you. This is me doing it. So I put the wire down. I hold it in place. Touch some solder. Then I hold it in place with my cold thing here. Let it cool so it doesn't fall off. Blow on it. Good luck. Goodness, that makes a racket. Brahms' third racket, to be exact. Now, I just simply bring this cable out. So now I'm going to hot glue this into place. It's ready. It's soldered. It loves me. I love it. And I've got a hot glue gun. And not only do I have a hot glue gun, I have a fuchsia hot glue gun. And you know I like that. So I'm just going to run a ring of hot glue inside the circle I made. Nothing fancy. It's the magnet that does all the work, so you don't have to really worry about the paper of the speaker. And I'm gonna just put the speaker in place using the circle that I drew. Lay it flat. Press on it. And kind of just let it cool. And there you have it. I've soldered and glued my speaker into place. Like so. Okay, when you're putting on the bottom, one of the things that Dr. Clark says is you cannot have any metal on top or below or anywhere on this. You can't have it, you can't use it on a metal surface, you can't have it on a metal shelf. What happens is metal reverses the polarity. For instance, when you stick a magnet to a piece of metal, the north part of the magnet makes the metal south because opposites attract. We don't want that. So everything's got to be plastic. And so I've bought these little nuts and bolts that are plastic. Pretty cool. We're going to put those into place in just a second. Alrighty. Now, here we have the bottom. And we're going to sandwich this in here, like this. Now the bottom, now that the speaker's in place, the bottom doesn't fit snugly down in. It's got this little bit of seesaw action here. So we're going to use force. Extreme force, a little bit of violence, and pressure. I'm going to give it pressure. It's still the same 1/8 inch drill bit that I use for everything. Keep it simple. I'm going to drill this square. This little square right in the center of it. I'm going to push down. I'm going to clean off the little scrackies that get in the way of the nut and bolt. And then I'm going to put them in there. I ain't going to let nothing get in the way. So there's that. And I can add the nuts to it immediately. Now I tell ya, these things are wimpy. The strip real easy. So you just want to finger tighten it. You'll get the feel for it after you've like messed up a bunch. You kind of just... The second it just has any resistance, you're done. Because the second after resistance, it's done. Plastic nuts and bolts. Can't take much. There. So you really don't need to do too much to that. Now, I'm gonna do the other side.
See how this guy's like jumping way up here?
Push down. Push down. Clean it off. And just do the same thing. And that's how we build a North Pole speaker box. The only thing we gotta do beyond this is we gotta add an alligator clip to the end of this guy. So those little chrome alligator clips make it so that if someone has a homemade 1000 hertz zapper, they can clip that to it with an alligator clip, or if they have one of ours, or they can simply use the banana plug. But that way this pretty much will fit any zapper the customer may have. It gives them the option to build their own or to buy a commercially made one. So we've got some of those right here. So these chrome slip-on guys slip on like that. And that's a North Pole speaker box, kids. Clean it off with your cleaning brush. And that's that. Let's widen up. And the customer can always test their North Pole. Like so.